Ladies and gentlemen, introducing at this time, he is the leader of excessive force.
I thought it was going to be on the infirmary.
And the current United States champion, Ace Anderson.
I know radio probably ain't gonna play this. But y'all going out in the hood, man. Like goddamn standing on the Gaza Strip somewhere, man. Yeah. We hear someone, we probably know him to it by now. After all, it's the American way, right?
Home of the brave and free.
It's America.
Free just to murder me.
Land of the handguns.
Land of the beautiful.
Home of the shotguns.
Now I already know Snake's not here. Because he already knows that he won the title.
Snake's gonna win away since.
So, you might as well just give it to me. You might as well just give me the Oscar title. Just give it to me. I got this, give me that, I'll lace this up with aces too. Come on.
I can't do that.
No, why not?
Because Snake is a new wrestler and you gotta give him a chance.
This is his first match. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Do you know what I've done? Because I've done it.
Yeah, I've done what you've done.
I've gotten the excessive force, the tag team championship.
I did. I learned my lesson.
I got the United States championship.
Yeah, you did.
Tell I broke through two world title changes. I'm on the top of the mountain.
You're the man. You're pulling all the strings. Been here 5 minutes and he's running the BWF.
Damn straight.
Well, then you don't need the Intercontinental title, obviously, if you're that much higher already.
I am Mr. BWF.
Hey!
Gonzalez right here, motherfucker. I just came out the woodwork. And right now, I'm gonna call this matchup. Who's in the back, man?
Oh, what a shoulder block right there by Mr. B.
Who the fuck are you? You get away from my commentation station. I'm Gonzalez. I'm the greatest commentator of all time.
You're just a play by play commentator.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I thought you were Nicholas. I'm sorry.
No.
I'm sorry. I'm Gonzalez. It's nice to meet you.
Yes.
What's your name? What's your name? Play-by-play, that's your name?
Yeah.
All
right, what a toss right there by Roland Havoc. Ace Anderson down now, favoring that back, and Havoc's going to work on the shoulder area, dropping that huge leg right across the arm of Ace Anderson.
You know, that's why Roman Harris is a great wrestler. He's attacking one of his main weapons that Ace Anderson likes to use, which is that right arm.
That right arm that he uses for all those strikes, because Ace Anderson tends to think of himself as one of the best pure strikers in the BEWA, and he has proven that he is a pretty damn good one with all those stiff strikes. Roman Harris now tossing him into the turnbuckle.
Put it in the midsection.
Which looks like Havoc's going. Suplex. Referee smartly getting out of the way. Havoc quickly going for pin. One, two. That was a pretty quick count by that referee. Ace Anderson able to get that shoulder up. Havoc. Trying to get Ace Anderson back up to the feet now. No, he takes him back down and he has him in. It should be like a side headlock there.
Roman Havoc applying more pressure to the headlock.
Havoc putting his whole body weight. Oh my! What kind of animal? What kind of animal just bites another man? Ace Anderson biting the forearm of Roland Havoc. Going back to work for Roland Havoc's forearm now. Oh, what an elbow drop there! At least wrenching that arm. I mean, this is pretty smart on the behalf of Ace Anderson, because most of Roland Havoc's offense comes from lifting his opponent. And without that one good arm, I don't think there's a way that Roland Havoc is going to be able to lift Ace Anderson up.
Ace Anderson is a small guy. He is pretty big. Very, pretty big for his size. You know, Roland Havoc loves to deliver that vertical a lot.
Yeah, he does love delivering that vertically.
Pretty big.
What's wrong, play-by-play? What's wrong? Is Gonzalez too much for you to handle? I'm very sorry that my greatness just emits such awesomeness. Yeah. I'm very sorry.
Yes. I mean, I can see how
that's
you...
That's right, man. You heard me correct. My greatness emits such awesomeness.
I think that there might be some more awesome people in the BWA than you, Gonzalez. That
who?
Might just be
who?
True.
Who? Give some examples.
I mean, what about the number one contender for the BEWA title, who's a part of Team Awesome, Eric Spade?
Eric Spade, he's not a commentator, though.
Eric Spade isn't a commentator, but...
I'm not talking about wrestlers. I'm talking about commentators. Commentators. I'm a commentator, not a competitor. Get your information right. Play by play.
I thought you were just talking about the whole BWA in general.
No. The commentators.
Just the commentators.
I'm a commentator. Am I in that ring right now? Have I ever been in that ring? No. And that's what a great commentator does. Even though he's talking about something else, he stays on top of the action.
Ace Anderson now finding himself back on the ground again. Roland Havoc. Roland Havoc trying to work the kinks out of that arm after Ace Anderson went to work with it. Oh, what a punch right to the jaw. Oh, and a slap in the mouth. You know, Roland Havoc loves doing that. He loves popping you in the mouth. And you're just sitting down on your ass. What a dick. But I love it. I love it.
So wait, are you saying that you love dick now?
No,
because that's
no,
kind of
no, play
that
by
is
play.
Kind of what that is.
No,
like.
No, play. I said Roland Havoc is a dick.
Oh, okay.
But I love his actions.
You love action?
His actions. Yes, I love action, like right now in this matchup between Roland Havoc and Ace Anderson.
Roland Havoc hanging Ace Anderson right there on that middle rope.
Deserves another.
Roland Havoc talking to the big guy of excessive force, Justin Tyrell. Justin Tyrell doesn't seem very fazed by any of the words that Roland Havoc has to say, though. Oh, Havoc going to the back now of Ace Anderson. Ace Anderson finding himself in a world of hurt and trouble at the moment. He's been spending a whole lot of time on the ground right now as Roland Havoc has been going to work.
Taking off his gloves. Why are you taking off his gloves?
I think he means business now.
His business. That means business.
I think things are gonna get serious at this point. Oh!
Chops. Oh, chops.
Chops right
nice
to the chest.
Ah.
Oh!
Ace answering those roundhouse kicks. He's going for
Ace Anderson. Looks like he's gonna. He thought about going for a suplex. Wait a minute. Ace Anderson wrenching at him. Oh.
What's he going for?
It's like he was going for a standing armbar, I think.
But it turned to like some sort of triangle armbar, which I don't think that's a move.
I don't think in all the years of BWA I've seen a move quite like this one, and now he's transitioning right to that front cross face there.
What the fuck?
Where's the Bible? Oh, Ace Anderson pulling the nose and eyes of Roland Havoc. The referee, how did he not see that? I mean, and Ace Anderson now transitioning to.
He's transitioning to
the other arm.
I don't see why he would let go of the crossface.
Yeah, one submission locked in. And this just shows the inexperience of the leader of the excessive force. Oh, man. Roland Havoc with his own reversal now.
No! This is why Roland Havoc is great. This is reversed a very terrible situation to a good position right here.
I definitely agree. This is why this man is the living legend. He's one of the last year one guys in the BWA. And by far, I think he might be the greatest BWA superstar that's still wrestling today. That is why they call him Mr. BWA. Ace Anderson now able to fight his way back, and he has Roland Havoc down, and he's trying to wrench that shoulder of Roland Havoc. He just puts his foot right into the shoulder blade of Havoc.
Ace Anderson being very, very aggressive in this matchup.
That kick was aggressive. With a big clothesline, not able to take Roland Havoc off his feet. Looks like he's gonna go for it again. And Roland Havoc was able to counter with him. A tackle of sorts, yes. Both men are down. The referee implementing that tackle. Roland Havoc able to get the hand over the chest. Ace Anderson able to just get that shoulder up with a two count. You have to imagine, you couldn't imagine what could be going through the head of Ace Anderson right now. I mean, he had 2 weeks and he was probably at hard
working very hard training to go against the competitor he thought he had in the Intercontinental Champion Snake, only to be surprised with Roland Havoc.
But you know, play by play, even if you knew Roland Havoc was your opponent, it's still kind of hard to prepare for that massiveness of just wrestling goodness. Like, it's tough. It's tough. Oh. It was even tough for Eddie Brooks. Eddie Brooks is great.
I mean, yes, right. Well, Eddie Brooks is fairly great.
Fairly.
I would say that.
Mean fairly great.
I mean, yes, he's a former BWA champion.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is true.
Yeah.
He's a former United States champion, as a matter of fact.
And
a
Continental.
And
twice.
Two times.
Yeah. Oh. Great.
You seem to know this. You seem to know Eddie Brooks' resume pretty well.
He's my
Mr.
client.
Gonzalez, yes.
He's my client. We're partners in the same business.
He's still your client?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
We're partners in the same business. When he makes money, I make money. When I make money, Eddie Brooks makes money. That's how we work.
All right, man.
Almost like we're the same people.
It does. It kind of does seem like you two could possibly be the same person, but that might just be impossible.
What are you talking about? No, it's impossible. I am Joao Jesus Gonzalez, the 32nd. My name is not Eddie the Dragon.
Ace Anderson, that step up insecurity. Roland Havoc might be out now. One, two.
Roland Havoc gets a shoulder up.
Havoc just showing. I don't know if he consciously got that shoulder up, or if that was just a reflex from all those years of wrestling that he has under his belt, but he was able to just get the shoulder up there, avoiding that three count.
No. It was a jerk. Let's not get carried away. No.
Referee
implementing that five count.
Ref staying on top of the action. Good job, ref. Good job. Director, good job. Implementing the rules, make sure everything's fair. Ace Anderson with a roundhouse kick to the back.
Right to the ribs.
Had him in the ref, you know he'll never mistake. Never hit.
Ace Anderson going back to work on that arm of Roland Havoc. Letting go just before that five count. Roland Havoc favoring that arm pretty heavily now.
I want to lose a match that way one time. I want to get
right to the chest.
I want the
Roland Havoc.
One, two. But Roland Havoc with that great ring awareness gets his foot on the bottom rope.
That just veteran ring presence of Roland Havoc, able to find the ropes with his feet. He didn't even need his eyes, ladies and gentlemen. He just knew exactly where he was in the ring, and he knew just how far he needed to stretch that foot out to break up that three count.
You can't touch the music.
Ace Anderson going through a little bit of frustration. Roland Havoc has Ace Anderson up. Ace Anderson up on his shoulders. That waist slam. Wait a minute. Just a Tyrell going into the ring.
Oh, Reaper.
Oh, Reaper's
out here.
Reaper.
Tag it to Tyrell.
Tag team partner.
He's giving Tyrell.
Able to get Justin Tyrell right off the ropes. Justin Tyrell going at it with Reaper right out here in front of us, ladies and gentlemen. This is just a very dangerous situation. Oh my God. They almost hit us.
Hey, Ace Anderson, you gotta pay attention, boy. Pay attention, boy.
Ace Anderson not paying attention. Roland Havoc. Roland Havoc. Hey, the verdict. Right in the middle of the ring. Ace Anderson down. One, two, three. Beat that bell. Roland Havoc beats Ace Anderson.
The title he never held.
Ace Anderson not only losing this match, but losing his thick belt that he holds so dear, that belt that he defaced, the only title that Roland Havoc has never won in his illustrious Starfield career, that United States title. Roland Havoc has finally won every single title in the BWA.
Okay, catch your breath. Play by play. That was a lot of talking right there, baby.
That was a lot. Woo!
Calm down. I know you're
trying. What eluded him for 6 years.
Yes!
Yes! Hey, Sam. Put those cars. Keep facing.
No!
The United States title. Roland Harris just ripping them off.
is knocked out on his feet, talking all this trash, talking about he wants the rematch. I don't think his body and mind can't comprehend that he just caught the most devastating move in the history of the BWA. He just lost that title fair and square in the middle of the ring. Chris Ballmer telling
Chris Ballmer
telling
the ball.
There's no rematch today. There's no rematch tomorrow. Hell, there's no rematch in 2 weeks at Fatal Finale.
He gets a rematch next year. Chris Ballmer dropping the huge bomb with Ace Hands in the world.
What more important?
I want a strip.
Somebody has requested to wrestle you.
Oh yeah, who? I haven't beaten already. Who?
You haven't beaten this guy already. I guarantee you that.
What isn't it?
But it is a guy that you fucked over in Eclipse.
Oh, fuck everybody over.
Wait. No. At Fatal Finale, it's Ace Anderson versus Samuel Masters.
Oh! What a big one! That's a big one right there, baby!
House!
Fuck over Samuel Masters! House!
Masters gonna kill you!
And the crowd knows the truth. The crowd's behind it. Screaming out, Masters gonna kill him because he is.
I think that the crowd knows the end result of this match.
This is gonna be amazing. Samuel Masters, greatness himself, is gonna destroy Ace Anderson at Fatal Finale.
U.S. title might be a little lower than where you're going.
Oh,
that was a compliment, you idiots.
Rolling Havoc, and just gained that six title, a belt he has never held before. And that's why he's great!
No, Mr. Gonzalez, he's not this great. He is Mr. BBWA.
You know what? Gonzalez is excited. I'm ready to party. I'm gonna celebrate.
That does sound like quite a good idea.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. We don't get drunk.
I got every championship.